Hello to all my students of class 10th. Welcome back once again. In my previous video, I was explaining you the subtopics of chapter resources and development. So to continue with that chapter where we were doing the classification of resources, where I told you that resources have been classified into four different categories, that is on the basis of origin, on the basis of exhaustibility, on the basis of ownership, and on the basis of status of development. Where already we did the two classification, that was the first one and the second one. So now we begin with the next classification, that is on the basis of ownership. Now when we talk about the on the basis of ownership, it has been further classified into four different categories. And the very first category is individual resources. When we talk about the individual resources, we are talking about those resources which are actually owned by an individual person and belongs to only that particular person. For example, a house which might belong to only one person, or a land, or a vehicle, or your school bag, or your study table, or your lunch box, or anything else which belongs only to a particular person. That is what we say, individual resources. The next one under this is a community owned resources. When we are talking about the community, we are talking about the society. So we include those resources under this which are accessible to all the members of the society or the community, means which belongs to all of us. For example, a park, a public park which belongs to each one of us, or any public places. It could be a temple, it could be a mosque, it could be a gurdwara, or let's talk about a cinema hall or a mall, any place, you know, a restaurant which belongs to you and me, to everyone in the society. That is what the community owned resources is. The next comes the national resource. Now when we talk about the national resource, the resources which has been related with our country. Now when we talk about the country, you know, we talk about those resources which belongs to our nation, to our country, and of course to all of us. And when we talk about such resources, we say it could be a mineral. Then all the minerals which have been found beneath this earth, it belongs to our country, right? It could be a water resources which belongs again to our nation, a forest again to our nation, when nation means to all of us, railways, you know, roadways which belongs to our country. That is what the national resource. Then the last one under this is our international resources. When we talk about the international resources, we are talking about all the resources, all those resources which belongs to the world. And when we talk, then as such, we talk about those resources which belong to all the nation at the same time. And it is just a resource which is, let's say, an ocean, you know, an oceanic resource, you know, which belongs to everyone. So we say a oceanic resource beyond 200 miles means beyond 200. Within 200, it belongs to a particular country only. Like if we talk about India, within 200, where our territory ends, within that 200, it belongs to us only. You know, we are allowed to take the things from that. But beyond that 200 miles, that's an open ocean, which belongs to everyone, that is to every nation, to every country. It could be used, could be utilized by all the countries, because that's an international resources, right? Now the question comes, that is the last one, the resource has been also classified on the basis of status of development. Now when we talk about the status of development, it has been further classified into four categories. When we talk about those four categories, that is the potential resource, developed resource, stock and reserve. So we talk about the very first one, that is the potential resources. Now when we talk about potential resources, these are those resources which are found, you know, which are found in a particular region and they might, but still it might have not been utilized. Means, these resources which have been found, which might found in that particular place, but still it is not been utilized over there. You know, for example, we talk about the Rajasthan and Gujarat area, which has been endowed with an enormous wind and, let's say, enormous potential of wind and solar energy. But still, you know, these have not been developed. That means that Gujarat and Rajasthan, they have a potential for the development of wind and solar energy, but so far these have not been developed properly. Then comes the next resource under this, that is the developed resource. When we talk about the developed resources, resources which are already been used, we are using it. We are using it because they have been surveyed properly and they have been utilized. Means the resources which have been surveyed, their quality and quantity has been identified, and now we are making it in a usable form. Because, you know, we had the technology, with that we were able to exploit it and we are using it in our life today. That is what the developed resources are. Then comes the third one under this, that is the stock. When we talk about a stock, the word itself is telling you, stock which you already have, right? You have, but you are not able to use it. Then what might be the reason behind it? So these are those resources which are available in an environment, jo hai, already it's there, and they do have a potential to satisfy our needs. But let's say, you know, we do not have that appropriate technology, a proper technology that we can make use of them. No, we do not have the technology or that level of feasibility we do not have, which can help us to make it access to them. So we are not able to use it, though they are there. There might be a number of the minerals which might be there behind this, below this, and you know, but we are not able to, below this land, I mean to say, but still they are, we are not able to use them. The reason is, might be we do not have that proper technology which could help us to exploit it. And that is the reason it is as a stock. They do have a potential, but still we are not able to use them. And the last one under this is a reserve. Now, when we talk about a reserve, means, of course, you know, it is again a kind of a stock, a reserve which we do have. So, which are kept as a reserve, you know, resources which we keep as a reserve, which could be used in future. Means, we have, but we have kept in reserve, which we are going to put in use somewhere in future with the technical know and how, and we are going to use it later in the later stage. For example, let's say we built a dam, and that water in the dam is a reserve. Why it's a reserve? Because somehow we are going to use that water in future. So that is what reserve is, that today you are keeping it, you are putting it in a reserve, you're keeping it as a subset of stock with a motive that in future it will be utilized. Because resources which we exploit today, we need to keep in mind that at the same moment you have to keep it for the coming generation also. So that is what the classification of resources are, where we are classifying the resources into different categories. Thank you. Hello to all my students of class 10th. Welcome back once again. In my previous video, I was explaining you the subtopics of chapter resources.